So now I'm gonna be washing my hands before I go see my patient. All right, now I'm gonna go see my patient.
Hello, my name is Pedro. I'll be your nurse today. How are you doing today?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. Could you please state your name and date of birth for me, please?
Sarah Chapin, February 1st, 1995.
Okay, just check right here. Perfect, all right. So I'm gonna be taking your vital signs, okay? Is that all right?
Yep.
Perfect.
Do you have any allergies to medications?
Nope.
Okay. Alright, so now that we're done taking your vital signs, do you know what medications you're on right now?
Yeah, I brought a list with me.
Perfect. Alright, I'll just double check this with my record. So, it says right here you have Vasotec, and do you remember what that does?
No.
So that one lowers your blood pressure.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Then you would have Actos, that one goes with your diabetes medication.
Okay.
Then you have Coreg. This one is for your increased heart rate. So this one will decrease your heart rate and your blood pressure.
Oh, okay.
Leukotrol, that's your another of your diabetic medications. Lasix, decreases exit fluid. So whenever you get swelling like you have right now in your legs, what we do is we use that Lasix and it flushes out that extra fluid for you.
Is that what's making me go to the bathroom all the time?
Yes, but that's good because that's a sign that the therapy is working. Potassium chloride, that one is used because Lasix, what it does, you have this electrolytes in your body that they have to be at a certain level, and when we're flushing things out like with Lasix, you would get a deficiency on that, so you'd have lower levels of potassium, so that's why we give you a supplement to prevent problems from that. And then lastly, we have Digoxin, and this one increases your cardiac output and heart rate, so basically it makes your heart work more efficient. Do you have any questions?
Nope.
All right, perfect. Hi, I see you turn on your call light.
Yeah, I was just watching TV and I saw a commercial for ACE inhibitors and I thought I should probably be on one of those.
You know what? It's kind of funny. You're actually on one right now.
Really?
Yeah.
Which one?
So the one that you're on right now is called Vasotec.
How does it work?
Okay, so... It's kind of a tricky process, but your body has this hormone, it's called the renin-angiotensin cascade, and basically what it does, I know it sounds kind of complicated,
yeah.
But what it does, it keeps salt from leaving your body,
mm-hmm.
And what that does, it increases the fluid, so like in your legs right now, you know how you have the swelling?
Yeah.
So that's because you have too much sodium, that's keeping fluid in. So what we do is we give you these medications like Vasotec, which inhibits the production of this salt-producing hormone.
Oh.
And in return, we kind of flush some of the fluid out. And that's how that one works.
Oh, that makes
sense. All right, so we're gonna be changing the route your furosemide is going on. You have any questions about that?
Is that one of the pills that I normally take?
It is. So what happens is that we're gonna change it from being taken orally as a pill to the IV, so it'll be infused in your vein. What that does for you, it provides a quicker treatment for you. The oral one usually takes about 30 to 60 minutes, but IV, it's right away. As soon as it hits your vein, it's in your bloodstream. So it makes it a lot quicker, and that should keep your stay healed here shorter, and you'll be up on your way. So.
Good. I feel like my heart's racing really fast. Do I have a medication that will slow my heart rate down?
You actually do. So what we have for you on board is a beta blocker. A beta blocker, so it's a medication that makes your heart rate more efficient. So kind of slow it down, but it makes your contractility stronger. So you're still getting the same amount of blood taken out, but with less beats, if that makes sense.
Oh, okay. Well, I have one last question.
Okay.
I sometimes worry about how will I know if I've ever taken too much?
Well, there's actually one that I would really keep an eye out on for. it's digoxin. So what this medication does, it kind of messes with your potassium levels, and basically it, people say it eats it away, but it decreases your levels of potassium, and it causes problems with your heart. So what that does, it just creates irregular beats on your heart, and it's really bad. So we want to keep really close attention to how much you're having for that digoxin and your levels of potassium.
So what types of like signs and symptoms should I look out for?
So some of the most common signs and symptoms you would see is you would start seeing bradycardia, which is the slowing of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
So you just kind of get a slower and slower heartbeat. And then also premature ventricular contractures, which if we had you on EKG, it's a device that shows how your wave, the waves of your heart, how it beats, you would see that usually you have a pattern, but this one you would start seeing it happen prematurely. So it wouldn't go perfect, it would actually go before it's supposed to go. So that would alert us that something is going on, that your heart is not in sync.
So what if I'm at home?
So if you're at home, you would see things such as really subtle symptoms, such as a headache, a nausea, vomiting, and also your heart. You know, you would start kind of feeling that something is wrong with your heart. You know, start feeling a, you know, different beat, I guess. Alright, so now we're going to get you started for discharge, okay? So, first thing we're going to go over is your medications. For those who want you to keep taking them as prescribed, so make sure you pay close attention to what time and how to take your medications, okay? Next, your activity, we're going to have you take it easy for the first few days, and then you'll resume to normal activity within a few days. Alright, then, so as far as your weight goes, I want you to self-weigh yourself in the morning. Same amount of clothing, same scale, same time. That way, make sure that those weights are accurate. If you see any weight increase of more than a pound in one day or more than 3 pounds in 1 week, we want you to notify us.
Okay.
Diet, we highly encourage the DASH diet. We'll give you more information as it comes closer to discharge.
Okay.
And then symptoms, those are very important for you to remember, okay? So if you see any changes in weight gain, we want you to immediately let us know, okay? Because that would mean that you're still retaining fluid, and that's not good.
Okay.
Additionally, you can also look for symptoms such as the vomiting, diarrhea, which may be complications of your medications, or anything unusual. So we've gone over the signs and symptoms that could mean that there's complications for your treatment. I'm going to make sure I leave my call light here with you. Do you have any questions before I go?
No.
All right, perfect. So I'm just going to make sure your bed is locked, which it is. All right, if you have any questions, let us know.
Okay.